Susan, what do you think? There's a conspiracy at the Boston Memorial Hospital involving all the anesthetists?
I've had a rather hysterical call from Dr. George in anesthesiology. Dr. George is a very powerful person here. Not only because of his position, there are other reasons.
I gather.
Now, what does that mean?
Just because somebody has got a rich wife, he shouldn't be able to throw his weight around.
Oh. You're looking for truth and justice, huh?
I'm looking for fairness.
Well, in fairness, Susan, you've challenged the professional competence of a chief of service at this hospital, and he didn't take it well. No reason why he should. Now he's out for blood.
I've noticed.
Sue, believe me, I'm on your side. For all kinds of reasons. Including the fact that I don't want to let another chief of service get one of my house officers fired.
Dr. Harris, I just wanted to look at his charts.
Sue, right now I can protect you. Because you're good. And frankly, because you're a woman.
I don't want any concessions.
Well, at the moment, you'd better take any you can get. You know what happened to Greenlee?
Yes.
What happened?
She died.
How do you feel about that?
How do I feel? I feel. She was my best friend. She understood me. She understood me. It's not fair. None of this is fair.
Here.
Nobody understands.
I know.
Nobody.
I know. Yes?
Dr. Harris, you have the secretary of HEW on the phone from Washington.
Call back. Too many of us shut ourselves off from our feelings. We don't explore them. We don't understand them. We don't understand ourselves. You're experiencing the toughest thing about our profession.
Dr. Harris...
I'll take care of the politics. You just look out for yourself. Take the weekend off, Sue. Go walk on the beach. Get away from the hospital.
I'm so embarrassed.
No, don't be. Don't be. Our emotions are what make us human. Come on. Come and see me next week, all right?
Right.
Good. Have a good weekend.
Thank you, sir.
Women. Christ.